The state of Arizona is rightfully considered to be one of the hottest states in the United States, hence its mostly arid desert climate. In these deserts, temperatures can reach up to 50 degrees Celsius or 122 degrees Fahrenheit. Because of this fact, you might be stunned to learn that around 10,000 years ago, the state contained one of the southernmost glaciers in the entire country. This glacier was once more than a mile in length and, at the time, was around 295 feet or 90 meters thick. Today, these glaciers are no more, having completely melted away more than 9,000 years ago. Yet, remnants of their existence can be found through moraines and glacial cirques, aka depressions, carved by their movement. These cirques can be found on the western section of the former San Francisco Mountains inner basin, along with the edges of its collapsed crater walls. And, outlined on screen in red, is the furthest extent these glaciers reached. The longest glacier was a little more than 2.5 miles in length, which helped to carve out steep valleys via a mass of ice, which was as much as 750 feet thick. These glaciers at a minimum existed only above 9,250 feet above sea level, with four originating adjacent to Humphreys Peak. Before I describe why exactly these glaciers formed in Arizona and when they existed, I am going to first remind my audience why such a large and fairly isolated mountain exists north of the city of Flagstaff. Although Arizona is generally not well known for this, the state contains two active volcanic fields which have both erupted in the last 1,000 years. One of these volcanic fields consists of more than 600 vents of various shapes and sizes scattered across an area of around 1,800 square miles. This field has erupted on average about once every 4,500 years for around 6 million years, creating a grouping of cinder cones, Mars, and lava dome complexes, with volcanism possibly being related to an underlying hotspot in the mantle, as vents on average get older to the west, matching the direction of tectonic plate movement. Between 1 million and 400,000 years ago, the majority of eruptive products occurred at a single vent instead of multiple vents, which largely only each erupted once. This formed a towering stratovolcano much like Mount St. Helens, which at the end of its lifespan was the tallest peak in the lower 48 US states, rising to a height of 16,000 feet. However, around 400,000 years ago, this volcano collapsed in a massive landslide, carving out a giant C-shaped crater to the east-northeast, leaving behind an assortment of scattered remnant peaks, the tallest of which today is Humphreys Peak. Although it is quite likely that the original San Francisco Mountain Peak volcano once was topped by thick glaciers due to its height, around 500,000 to 400,000 years ago, this cannot be proven due to the original deposits, if they once existed, having been obliterated by the massive ancient landslide. While the highest valleys on the mountain would become the site where glaciers would grow, they also began growing within the inner valley directed to the east-northeast. This is because, despite being at a lower elevation, the valley was kept at a colder temperature than other terrain in Arizona which is at similar elevations. Whereas Humphreys Peak now has an average temperature of around 33 degrees Fahrenheit, around 20,000 years ago, during the last glacial maximum, it averaged 16 degrees Fahrenheit. As, during the Ice Age, Arizona was on average as much as 14.4 degrees Fahrenheit or 8 degrees Celsius colder than it is today. The vast deserts did not exist, as instead grasslands and woodlands existed in their place. This makes sense when you consider that this temperature difference would be like the climate of the city of Phoenix, which is desert, becoming like the modern climate in the city of Payson, which is surrounded by dense forests, not a desert. During the last 400,000 years, glaciers were not always present on San Francisco Mountain, having only existed for 46% of the time as the climate naturally fluctuated over long timescales. Thus, glaciers expanded on this peak in Arizona between 375 and 340,000 years ago, 278,000 to 252,000 years ago, 190,000 to 135,000 years ago, and 70,000 to 10,000 years ago. During their peak, you could theoretically have gone skiing or snowboarding down the mountain any time of the year for as much as 60,000 years straight, as at their furthest extent, these glaciers covered a total of 3.4 square miles consisting of 1.4 cubic kilometers of glacial ice. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.